Okay, so today we'll discuss about soaps and Sindet bars. So what are soaps and what are Sindet bars? So as we all know, soaps are basically the sodium or potassium salts of long chain fatty acids. So when the triglycerides in the fat or oil react with the aqueous sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, they are converted into soap and glycerol. We know the reaction is called saponification, and it is basically the alkaline hydrolysis of esters that is happening. Since this reaction leads to the formation of soap, it is called the saponification process. So what is the saponification process? When the triglycerides in the fat or oil react with aqueous NaOH or KOH, they are converted into soap and glycerol. This is called saponification. So for a good cleaning action, the fatty acid unit in the soap should have 12 to 18 carbon atoms. If the fatty acids contain less than 12 carbon atoms, they are highly soluble in water. And if they contain more than 22 carbon atoms, they are insoluble in water. What are the advantages of using soap? They are excellent cleansers, especially in soft water. And then they are non-toxic in nature. They are derived from renewable resources and they are biodegradable. So the calcium or magnesium soaps may be used as lubricants and dryers. Lead soaps may be used as adhesives. Iron, nickel and zinc soap may be used for waterproofing leather and canvas. Similarly, aluminium and chromium soap may be used for sizing papers. There are different types of soaps. We have soaps like hard soaps, which are mainly used for washing purpose, washing clothes. So the sodium and salt of the fatty acids, which are prepared by saponification of cheap oils or fats with caustic soda, is called hard soap. So in hard soap, for the saponification process, we use cheaper oils or fats along with the alkali to get the sodium salt of the fatty acid or the soap. So what happens is that it contains free alkali and it may also contain sodium silicate, white clay as fillers. Cheap perfumes are used, so they are low quality and we need it for not for the skin, it is basically for washing purposes. Then there are soft soaps or toilet soaps. Here the potassium salts of the fatty acids are prepared by saponification of the best quality oils and fats with a calculated quantity of caustic potash. So these are the soft soaps. They usually contain a number of additives such as dyes, perfumes, creams, oils, and a bactericide. They are more expensive and they are soft in consistency. They also produce a soft lather and are more soluble. So they do not contain any free alkali like the hard soap. So they are not harmful to the skin. So usually the soft soap include the liquid soaps that we use, the toilet soap, shaving creams, shaving sticks, shampoos. All these use the soft soaps. There are also medicated soaps or antibacterial soaps. So the toilet soaps containing bactericidal ingredients such as the carbolic acid or its derivatives are called medicated soaps. Then there are transparent soaps. So these are clear soaps having high glycerin content or glycerol content. So you know the peers, you see the picture down. Mainly it has a lot of glycerin in it. It is less drying. So it is basically moisturizing the skin. It doesn't dry the skin like the other opaque soaps. Also, it can have additional emollient oils such as shea butter, jojoba oil, which are added for further moisturizing and emollient purpose. So, they are partly soap and partly solvent in nature. The sodium hydroxide causes big crystals to form in soap. That's why the soap is usually opaque in nature. However, if we have to make the soap transparent, as we have seen in the this pure soap or other such soap, we have to dissolve the soap in enough solvent so that the crystals are so small, so that light passes through the soap, and that's why it becomes transparent. So what are the solvents that can be used? Glycerol, alcohol, glycerol alcohol mixture. These are some of the solvents that can be used to make the crystals light, so small. Which crystals? The sodium hydroxide crystals, which are big, makes the soap opaque. So if you use enough solvent, the crystals become small so that light passes freely through it, which makes the soap look transparent. There are also baby soaps. They are not much different from the ordinary soaps, but they are comparatively of high purity. So baby's skin is soft and sensitive. We know that a small baby's skin is very soft and sensitive. So the oil which is used to make the baby soap should be clean and bleached. No pigments are allowed in baby soap, and fragrance materials which are added should be bare minimum. Only very minimum perfume or such fragrant material should be used. So the free alkali content present in baby soap should not exceed 0.05%. So ordinary soap may contain rosin and metallic impurities such as nickel. Okay, so these may be present in the ordinary soaps. So what about liquid soaps? Liquid soaps, they are more effective than the flake soaps, and there is smaller chance of residue being left when you use the liquid soap. So how do you prepare this soap, liquid soap? So from the coconut, you take coconut oil, caustic potash, usually 24%, borax, glycerin, sugar, water in the required as per the formula. And you heat the coconut oil in a jacketed kettle at about 50 degree centigrade. Then you agitate it with potash lye. What is potash lye? It is a caustic white deliquescent solid, potassium hydroxide, which may also be used as a bleach. So it's basically used in manufacture of soap, and it's called caustic potash or lye or potash. So you're treating the coconut oil with this potash lye. Then you add the borax and glycerin, and then you stir it with known quantity of water and filter it with perfume and coloring matters. So what the soap does? Usually the soap or detergent will dissolve in the water, and it you can see it has a hydrophobic tail and hydrophilic head. You can see the these soap molecules, they are so they go and attach to the grease, and then they separate the grease from the surface, and the process continues, and you can see the micelles are formed, and it is, the grease is removed from the surface. So it has surfactant, it's surfactant in nature, and so next, what are the raw materials used for preparing soaps? Basically, we use the, we know that soaps are the sodium or potassium salts of the fatty acids. So the fatty acid mixture containing the saturated and unsaturated and long chain fatty acids in the suitable proportion is usually used. And we already discussed the fatty acids should have between 12 to 18 carbon atoms. So which are the which are the fatty acids that can be used? lauric acid, myristic acid, palmitic, stearic and oleic acids. So these can improve the solubility and lathering properties. To improve the solubility and lathering properties, basically we mix the coconut oil with tallow. That is usually obtained from animal fat. So the fish oils, palm oil, coconut oil, these are all used in the preparation of soaps. So what are the alkalis? Caustic soda and caustic potash may be used to make soft soaps. So potassium carbonate and soda ash may be used to saponify the fatty acids. What are the other additives that are used apart from the fatty acids and the sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide? We also need to use antioxidants so that the soap will not get rancid, which is used to stabilize the soap against rancidity. Example, sodium silicate, sodium hyposulfite, sodium thiosulfate, then whiteners like titanium dioxide and zinc oxide are used to improve the whiteness. Perfumes are used. Usually the pH of the soap is around 10. The selected perfume should be stable in this particular pH range. Then, what about the types of fats? We have different types of fats like unsaturated fats, saturated fat, trans fat. For example, we can use unsaturated fats include the in food. We say that almonds, vegetables, fish oil, olive oil, they are all and they contain unsaturated fat. Then there are also saturated fats like beef, butter, pizza, all these have. So what happens is that there is cis fat, there is trans fat, there is saturated fat. Now all these, only the cis fat is supposed to be good. This particular fatty acid molecules having the cis conformation. While the trans fat, where the molecules are, you can see to the opposite side, there's the isomerism. So they are bad. Similarly, the saturated fats also are bad. Saturated or trans fats are generally bad for health. Okay, that is with respect to food items, it may be a problem. But in the case of, now let's go to soap manufacturing. So, what are the processes you can use for manufacturing of soap? We can use the cold process. In this process, what is then the strong alkali and fat are mixed at room temperature so that emulsification takes place. So saponification is completed after this mixture is run into frames in several days at warm temperatures. So you allow it to undergo saponification for several days at warm temperature. Then there is the semi-boiled process. The semi-boiled process differs from the cold process in the fact that the saponification mixture is heated to 70 to 90 degrees centigrade using a steam heated coil, which can accelerate and complete the saponification process. So here we are heating it to 70 to 90 degree. In the other cold process, we are using just the warm temperature. So here the dyes, perfumes, additives are added at the end of the process, so that it will not evaporate. We know that perfumes and all, they are usually volatile. So towards the end of the process only you add the perfumes, dyes and such additives. So this process, this semi-boiled process allows the quantity of soda undergoing saponification to be adjusted before the crude soap is drawn off. It also allows manufacturing waste to be recycled, better incorporation of additives and a wider choice of raw materials. Now there is another process called the continuous saponification process, which is used when the production is on a very large scale. So for large scale manufacture of soap, we use the continuous saponification process. So what is done? The fats are first converted into fatty acids and glycerin using high pressure in continuous fat splitting process. So there are some more types of soaps like transparent soap, bathing bar, castile soaps. These are vegetable based soaps which are free from the animal fat, tallow, etc. So it's free from the animal fat. It's available as liquid castile soaps. These kind of soaps have good lathering, cleansing and moisturizing properties. There are also super fatted soaps and carbolic and carbonated soaps. So that's about generally about the hard soap, soft soap, liquid soap, etc. Now there are also another set of soaps which are called Sindet bars. Okay, so they are, you can say they are soap Sindet bars or soap free soaps. So of course they are synthetic in nature, but they are milder. You know the Dove soap, right? Very familiar with the Dove soap. So it contains milder surfactants like sodium cocyl isothionate, or which is derived from coconut, the coconut oil, or sodium palmitate may also be used. So they use less alkaline salts in their surfactants. So they have a much lower pH, which makes them less irritating. So the first Sindet bar that has been introduced is the Dove soap. It was introduced as early as the 1955. So it's made primarily from the sodium lauryl isothionate, but it contains sodium tallowate and palmitate as well. So Sindet is a blended word. It's a combination of two words, synthetic and detergent. So technically it's a cleansing product. So it is the synthetic, or it is combined, it is the blend. Sindet means it's a combination of the word synthetic and detergent. So technically it's a cleansing product which is made by binding of different synthetic detergents. So they are less alkaline than natural soap. So they will not harm the acid mantle. So what are the ingredients used in Sindet bars? Sodium cocoyl isothionate, which is a gentle surfactant and emulsifier. It is the most widely used and it is commonly known as baby foam due to its exceptional mildness. So there are some, these are some of the ingredients used in the Sindet bars. There are also sulfosuccinates, alpha olefin sulfonates, alkyl glycerol, ether sulfonate, sodium cocyl monoglyceride sulfate, and betaines. Okay, so what's the difference between the soap and the Sindet bar? Soap is extremely effective in cleansing the skin. It strips away everything, including our skin's natural oil. So the general soap that we use is basically stripping the skin away from the skin's natural oils. Soaps are known to be harsh and its use can damage the skin layers which regulate the hydration of our skin. Soap bars also have a pH ranging from 9 to 10, which makes it so it is more alkaline in comparison with the skin, which is having a slightly acidic pH. So the Sindet bars have a pH of usually 5.5. So the skin pH is slightly acidic, between 5 to 6. So the Sindet bars will naturally be mild and cause less damage to the skin. So the Sindet bars are around 5.5 pH and it is similar to the natural pH of the skin. They are effective cleansers, cause minimal damage to skin layers, and do not have the harsh stripping effects of the regular soap. So that's about Sindet bars. So Sindet bars are milder soaps, and they are a blend of the word synthetic and detergent. So they are less alkaline than the natural soap. So it will not harm the acid mantle of the skin. So the skin pH is around 5.5 to 5 to 6. So these Sindet bars, like the Dove soap, they are less alkaline and they have low pH, which makes them less irritating. And they have they are usually have milder surfactants like sodium cocyl isothionate or sodium palmitate, and they are like you don't use the harsh alkalis like sodium hydroxide and all when you are so you can use milder surfactants when you make these kind of Sindet bars. So these are the ingredients used in the Sindet bar: sodium cocoil isothionate. This is basically from coconut oil, and it is also called baby foam because of its exceptional mildness. Then there are sulfosuccinates, alpha olefin sulfonates, alkyl glycerol ether sulfonate, and sodium cocoil monoglycerol sulfate, as well as betaines. So we saw the difference between the soaps and Sindet bars. While the soaps are harsh and can damage the skin layers, it can remove the natural oil, strip the natural oil from the skin, and their pH is 9 to 10, while the Sindet bars are mild and cause less damage to the skin. The pH of the Sindet bars are usually around 5.5, which is similar to the natural pH of the skin. So they are effective cleansers and can cause minimal damage to the skin layers. So this is about soaps and Sindet bars. Okay, any doubt? We discussed about the different types of soaps, the process of making the soap. What are the types of soaps? The hard soaps or the washing soap, soft soap or the toilet soaps, medicated soaps, transparent soaps, baby soaps, liquid soaps. And they are prepared basically by the saponification process, and they act as surfactants. So they have a hydrophilic and hydrophobic part, and you can see how it is stripping the grease away from the surface and cleaning the surface. So one thing to note is that the saturated fatty acids should have between 12 to 18 carbon atoms, and what are the additives that may also be used in the soap: antioxidants, whiteners, these are opacifying agents also, titanium dioxide, then perfumes. So the it should be matching with the pH of the soap. There are different processes that are used for manufacturing soap, include the cold process, semi-boiled process, and continuous saponification. Okay, so this is about the soaps and Sindet bars. Thank you.